can say maybe the same, you know. So when the oceanic lithosphere, subducts under another oceanic lithosphere, this is oceanic or continental. Then this gives rise to subduction. So this is trench. So this is subducting slab or plate. Subducting plate or subducting slab. This is called overriding plate. This is how we name them. Overriding plate. So there I gave you the example, you know, in west coast of America. Like this, west coast of America, you have this subduction. The Pacific plate is subducting under the American plate. This is continental. This is continental. This is oceanic. So this is subduction. So here you have Peru, Chile trench. Peru, Chile trench. Here is your Juan, same thing you use, Juan D, Kipa trench. These are the trenches, you know, which are responsible for the specific ocean or specific plate getting subducted under the American plate. So this is subduction. Now when you go to collisions, the right example is Himalaya. Himalaya or Alps. So in this case, similarly, you know, this side of Pacific, the other side of Pacific is Japan. Here is Alaska. Alaska or Aleutian trench, Japan, Kuril trench, then we come back Philippines, Mariana trench. Here also the subduction is going on this way. Like this. So here I have told you, partly this is oceanic, partly this is oceanic. China will come here, right? Partly it is oceanic, so the subduction is sometimes reverses. Now it is subducting towards the continent, sometimes before, you know, it was subducting this way. This type of flip-flop, this is called a flip-flop subduction. This I have shown you some map, okay? Flip-flop subduction. So this happens when two oceanic plates interact. Now you see Himalaya and Alps, you know, where is Himalaya and Alps? Right from Mediterranean Ocean goes like this, you know, Himalaya comes like this. So this is your Alps. This is Himalaya. You come this side, you know, this side is Assam, Burma. Those areas. So here, this is the subduction zone. Initially there was subduction here. Initially the Indo-Australian plate or Indian plate was subducting under Eurasian plate. But later on, see initially how they were existing, I will draw a sketch map somewhere here. Initially this was India. Suppose here is India. India is a continental plate. Continental plate, you can keep this symbol. Continental plate. And from here is the oceanic. This is oceanic. I am just giving it a view section of view. This goes and subducts here under China. China was continental plate. Continental plate. So initially it was a subduction. Because Pacific, Tethys Ocean was closing and you have an oceanic plate there. The front part of Indian plate was oceanic. So this subduction, you know, continued from when? Say Jurassic period. From Jurassic period, this abduction continued up to the Eocene, Paleocene Eocene. So this plate, you know, started coming, Jurassic time onward, you know. It started at Jurassic, ended in the Eocene, means subduction part. Then this point, you know, this Indian plate came here, came to the trench. ऐसा हो गया, ओशियनिक प्लेट वेंट डाउन, सो कॉन्टिनेंटल प्लेट केम, दैट इज ड्यूरिंग यूएसए, सो नाउ कोलिजन हैपेंड, नो मोर सबडक्शन, दिस डिडंट अलाउ यू नो द कॉन्टिनेंटल प्लेट टू गो दिस, सो दैट इज कॉल्ड कोलिजन, सो इट एंडेड विद द कोलिजन, सो सिंस यूएसए और मायोसिन, यू नो मायोसिन क्लियर, वी आर फेसिंग दिस कोलिजन, मायोसिन टू टिल टुडे दिस कोलिजन इज हैपनिंग. So now, India and China together because of this collision of process. There is no ocean there. But earlier there was a large ocean existing between India. So this is a process of subduction followed by collision. Understood? Now, what you see today, there are two forces, you know, two types of force, you know, force or stress, whatever you say, that matters for rate of subduction. Suppose one plate, it starts here, you know, it subducts, this is mid-oceanic ridge. It was an degree and it is subducting here under this plate A and B, you know, A and B. So now below what you have this convection loop, huh? Like this. From this side the convection loop is coming like this, convection loop. So they are converging here, the convection loops. They are converging in the subduction zone. Converging in the subduction zone. The diagram you are understanding. So now the rate of subduction depends on how fast this ridge is pushing. How fast? Its spreading rate depends on that. And what else? How fast this is allowing? This plate is not allowing this plate to go down. This plate is not allowing this plate to go down because this is resistive. This is resistive. So this is called slab pull force. This is slab push force. So pushing from mid-oceanic this side and pulling from at the subduction zone. How fast it is being pulled? So if the resistance is more, the pull force will be less. So depending on these two forces, you know, so the rate of subduction is decided. The rate of subduction is decided. Now in case of collision, this is a maximum. In case of collision, here the resistance is so much. So there is no subduction because the resistance is so much. China plate is opposing. India plate, since it is a continental plate now, that is not also very heavy to go down. So the resistance is maximum. So subduction is almost nil. Very little subduction. But same time, this is also pushing. Try to understand this part. This is pushing. So how this pushing force is being maintained or balanced when you are not allowing this side to happen? How this side is working? You don't understand this part, na? So what he explains, you know, you don't see one reach to one subduction. Yeah, pushing ho raha, yeah, pulling me. Don't see that way. You see the total amount of push, you know, of all the mid-oceanic ridges, and total amount of pull, you know, all subduction zones, they are balancing. they are balancing.
You don't understand this part, na?
If you see the tectonic map, there are so many subduction zones on the western side of America. So many long subduction zones. You know. Their subduction rate is very fast. Subduction rate is that is taking care of no subduction here in case of India. So total subduction rate or total subduction destruction of the plates amount should be same as the amount of creation. Total, not one to one. If you see the map, I'll show you one map. Along some subduction zone, if collision is happening, where subduction is less or very little, the more amount of subduction will happen in other subduction zones. So, like here, you see, this part, Japan, or this part, and this part, here is a very smooth subduction. The Pacific plate is heavy, and it is meeting a continental plate. So, here, subduction is very fast. I told you that, then, the subduction is so fast, you know, it has reached the Miocene ridge. Why a Miocene ridge is existing very close to the North American coast? It is because the subduction rate is very high. Similar also here. Similarly here, everywhere subduction rate is very high. Because it is a smooth subduction. The oceanic plate is subducting under a continental plate. But if you go to this part, you see, this entire route, you know, this zone was initially subduction when it was very smooth. But now, India plate has touched the Eurasian plate. Similarly, this side, Africa plate has touched the Eurasian plate, producing Alps and Himalaya. So now there is no subduction. Only collision is happening, very little, little amount of push is going on. But from this side, the opening is happening. So you do not see balance between this and this. That cannot, can never be equal. But if you combine, you know, all the subduction, amount of destruction along this zone and the amount of creation along this zone, you know, this will remain same. So that is why sometimes people ask these questions, you know. The African plate. African plate, the northern side, you know, very little subduction. Very little subduction. Because it is a Miocene, it is a collision zone. But behind you see such a big Miocene ridge. How this is balanced? So it is balanced somewhere else. So total destruction and total creation should be same. Not one to one, it is correlated. Now, point is this part. When there is a collision here, there is opposite force working here. So this Indian Ocean, you know, is under destruction. Indian Ocean here, just south of India, it is under stress, under deformation. This part will read little later. The deformation of the Indian Ocean, little later. But now, let us only confine to subduction zones, some properties of subduction. So one is, these two forces which balance each other. One more property I will tell you. Imagine when it opened up, when it opened up, there must be some Medusa Nigris somewhere. It must have output voluminous amount of lava, you know, from the asthenosphere. That is what it has happened. So this ocean floor must have a good stratigraphy, you know. There must be good distribution of different rock types. So if you put a drill hole here, you know, so you will find first is your sedimentary layers. This is a sedimentary layer. Maybe 2 to 3 kilometers, you know, there may be sedimentary layers. Followed by what? Pillowed basalts, pillow lava. So this is the sequence, you know. You will get in all the ocean floors, then pillow lava cover, seated dike for understanding, huh? There will be numerous parallel dikes, you know, in the ocean floor. In fact, they are the carrier of lava. They are the feeder dikes. They all feed lava to this area. Then below seated dike, you will find gabbro, this trondhjemite, they say you can write plagiogranite, you know. Then if you go down, peridotite, lerzolite, the spelling they say, lerzolite, ultra basic rocks, gabbro basic rocks, then seated dike, mostly dolerite, then basalt, then sedimentary carbonate. So this is the sequence of the ocean floor. This is the stratigraphy of ocean. So this was the thing over which the sedimentary cover, you see. That is how this is happening. So follow this point. Now this margin, this ocean has two continents, you know, Indian continent here, Eurasia continent here. So this margin will be active margin. This will be active continental margin. Active continental margin. And this one will be the passive continental margin. Because here there is no deformation, there is no magmatic eruption, because this is the very calm and quietly the sediments are being deposited. But you see this part, sediments are being deposited, but there is a subduction zone, you know, deformation will be going on, magmatism will be happening. So that is why it is an active continental margin. Suppose I ask you, the west coast of America, is it a PCM or SCM? So this is called PCM, sometimes short note terms, SCM. The west coast of America is a PCM or SCM? SCM, active continental margin, because subduction is happening there. And suppose I ask you, the east coast of America is a PCM, because you have a Medusa Nigris at the center, both sides things are opening, you know. So along the continental, you understand, na? You see, this is Western America, this is South America. Here is the subduction zone. Is that not? For this side of America, you have Medusa Nigris here, Mid Atlantic Ridge. This side will be Africa. Africa will be here. Africa. So these continental margins, they are PCM. No deformation, no magmatism is happening here. But what happened? This part, active continental margin. Would you follow this point now? Suppose I ask you India. India on either side, you have passive continental margin. That is why you are always going for, you know, oil deposits. Because it is calm and quiet. So passive margins are more important for oil deposits, hydrocarbon deposits. You need a stable environment where life can prosper. After their burial, they will produce hydrocarbon. So PCM margins are more important. Similarly, suppose I ask you, you will look for oil here or you will look for oil here? Definitely you will look for oil here, you know, because this is a passive continental margin. It is a stable platform. Rocks will be deposited, you know, in a calm and quiet environment. There won't be any magmatism. So you will get oil. So now if you see the American coast, you know, American coast. The Mexico is the maximum reservoir of oil. Mexico. Why? Because this is a PCM margin, you know. No disturbance is happening. Sediments are being deposited in a very over a large platform, calm and quietly, you know. Could you follow this point, na?
So this is the difference between PCM and SCM. SCM means where subduction zones are. Lot of volcanism is happening. Deformation is going on. Could you follow this point, na?
So that is the distinction between SCM and PCM.
Okay.
Now, you come back. So you have this succession here. You have this succession. Here, this one. This is that stratigraphic success in your skin. Now, this is sedimentary success. This is the oceanic rock section, igneous rock section. These two now are moving, just like a boat, you know. This is moving toward the trench. So this is your trench. This is moving toward the trench. Same time, this plate is also moving this side. So this trench is shifting its axis. Trench axis is like this. Trench axis is like this. So this point will be shifting. Now, if I see this trench, you know, in a third dimension. Third dimension of the thing, how it extends, you know. Now, suppose this is I. So this is a plate. So imagine your earth surface is like this. Earth surface is like this. Understood, na? Now, this subduction zone, imagine for ASA. ASA curvature. ASA. Understood, na? This subduction zone you are seeing here. This is your R surface. R surface is spherical and you are cutting it like this. Cutting it like this. So what is asking? How this will appear on the third dimension? That is what is asking. So that is how the trench will appear if you look from the surface. From the sky, if you look, the trench will appear in that way. So this is a curved surface. Now, you are cutting it this way. What is telling? You just have two balls. This is one ball. There is another ball, you know, like this. It is cutting. So how will this surface for the third dimension? This will appear like this. It will appear like this. So this is your trench in a third dimension. That is why it appears like an arc. It is never a straight line. It is never a straight line. But this arc, that arcuate nature, you know, will tell you which is the subduction zone. You don't understand this part. No? So when you discuss this thing, the way it is subducting, you know, the curvature will be that way. You remember the Himalaya case of Himalaya. Himalaya is subducting to the north. So it is arcuate this way. Why? Because it is a subducting point. Yahan bhi, idhar bhi aap dekhoge. Aisa. Forget about that part. This is, I have told you, this is called a promontory. Two arcs are meeting there. Promontory it is called. We will discuss about Himalaya, you know, after this. Because I am discussing this subduction zone in reference to Himalaya. So after this, I will just taking up on this Himalaya case. Himalayan petrol. Now point is, so in third dimension, the trench is arcuate. That is why the name comes island arc. Island arc will come from here. Why it is an arc? The reason is this. Trench is an arc. Trench is not a straight line. It is an arc. The islands will appear here now. Volcanism will take place here. So they will follow parallel to art, follow to the strength. That is why you will produce an island art. Similarly, magmatic art will come. The definitions are very, but you remember why it is an art. It is not a straight line. It is not a linear arrangement of the things. Now, point is, you see, so this is your trench. Understood, na? Now if you see the trench, you just see the trench after a few million years, if you see the trench,
which way it is moving? The train should be moving this side, na? The train should be moving this way. This plate is abducting that side, if I am this. But the train should be moving this side, na? This is the movement direction. This is the movement direction. Though, if somebody says on the subduction, India plate is not moving this way. India plate is going towards north. China plate is coming towards south. But I am asking the trends. Trends is moving towards south. Similarly, American case also, it is moving towards the west. So, what is its forward direction? Forward direction is opposite to the trends, right? See, opposite to subduction. The train is moving this side, opposite to subduction. So, it's forward movement. If I say somebody, which way moving? Like this, you know, this is the train I am standing here. Next year I am going here. Next year I am going here. This is my forward direction. This is my backward direction. Naturally, subduction is going this way. But my movement direction is decided by how trench moves. Maybe I say, which way the foreland will lie? The way I am moving, na? Main aise move kar raha hu. My foreland will be there, na? My hinterland will be where? Yeah. That's all. So this side will be foreland. This side will be hinterland. Doubt नहीं रहा मैं इसमें. So Rocky Andes trench और Peru Chile trench, which side is foreland? Foreland is in the ocean, hinterland is in the state. Understood ना? Similarly go to Japan, which is foreland? Foreland is towards China, hinterland is in the Pacific Ocean. The opposite, I told opposite. Yeah. In case of Japan, the subduction zone is like this. The train is moving this way. So foreland is here. Hinterland is here. You know, understand this basic difference between which is foreland, which is backland or the hinterland. Suppose I say tomorrow, you know, Shivalik is the hinterland complex or foreland complex of Himalayan? Foreland. Why foreland? Whose four? Whose four is this? चाइना का फोर नहीं, वो ट्रेंस का, ट्रेंस का फोर है वो. ट्रेंस किस तरह मूव कर रहा है, दैट इज हाउ द फोरलैंड विल बी डिसाइडेड. हिंटरलैंड विल बी चाइना, चाइना विल बी हिंटरलैंड. फॉलो दिस पॉइंट ना. सो नाउ सो दिस इज ट्रेंस, दिस इज फोरलैंड, दिस इज क्लियर दिस पार्ट ना. Now, suppose I ask you, here there will be an island. Here there will be an island. Suppose there will be volcanism will take place here. An island will be created. This will also appear as earthquake itself if island takes place. Suppose I ask you, four arc. Suppose I say four arc and back arc. Which will be four hour, which will be back hour? इधर क्या होगा? Four hour. इधर क्या होगा? Back hour. Understood ना? Why four hour के ना back hour sir decided? How it is decided? Decided with respect to this motion only. Which way the train is moving? That will tell you four direction. Clear ना? Four land, back land or hinter land, four hour, back hour. So suppose tomorrow says somebody says there is a four arc basin. Four arc basin, you kidhar hoga? Four arc basin will be created here, na? Four arc basin will be created here. Arc means island arc, you understand? This is the island. Island will be created here, not anywhere else. Four arc means iska samne. Trench se pehle. Trench se pehle. With respect to this, we are discussing. बैक आर्क बेसिन बोलेगा सपोज कोई, व्हेयर इट बी क्रिएटेड, इट बी क्रिएटेड हियर. सो दैट मींस इफ देयर इज अ बेसिन लाइक दिस, इट इज अ फोर आर्क बेसिन. देयर इज अ बेसिन लाइक दिस, इट इज अ बैक आर्क बेसिन. बैक आर्क बेसिन बिकॉज़ दिस इज द आर्क. आर्क मींस आइलैंड आर्क, रिमेंबर, और मैग्मेटिक आर्क, वोल्केनिक इज हैपनिंग. Let us take the case of Andaman Islands. Andaman Island, you know. Where is Andaman Island? India is like this. Andaman Island. This is Andaman.